Hi guys, Teacher Janelle here. Hello there. We are going to be talking about multiple intelligences in this video. Yes, I want to talk about it because I came across some people who thought that, well, this is not a very new issue. This has been going on since then because this is a very conventional idea that intelligence is only when you are good at math. And when you are good at speaking, when you're good at English, it means you are intelligent. But according to Howard Gardner, the author of the Multiple Intelligences, who has conducted a lot of studies to prove that, the math, numbers, and words, English, they're not the only measure of human intelligence. Basically, he had 7 multiple intelligences, and eventually it has been added now, and then I lost count of how many there are now. There have been additions that's included in the list, but basically there were 7 multiple intelligences. So we begin with a very famous verbal linguistic intelligence. That is when someone is very good at speaking, writing, communication. That's your verbal linguistic intelligence. You are intelligent that way. Then we have the logical mathematical intelligence. So logical mathematical, numbers, logic, reasoning. So if you have very good reasoning, deductive reasoning, numbers, logic, if you are so good at that, you have a logical mathematical intelligence. Let me cite some famous people who have high logical mathematical intelligence. So, logical mathematical, what I have in mind is Bill Gates, Sir Isaac Newton. And for verbal linguistics, what I have in mind is Oprah. Yes, Oprah, yes, you know Oprah, the talk show host. Oprah has high verbal linguistic intelligence. And Maya Angelou, you know the author, Maya Angelou. Yes, she has high verbal linguistic intelligence. And let's not forget Shakespeare. Yes, William Shakespeare, who has written, he's got a lot of plays, poems. Next. Spatial intelligence. There's such thing as spatial intelligence? Yes, there is. Spatial intelligence, this is a person's ability. Your ability to see directions, see pictures in your mind, see patterns in your mind. Usually those who sketch, those who draw, those who paint, they have very high spatial intelligence. A person who easily remembers directions, where to go, how to do it, where to go. That's a person with a spatial intelligence. So I can only name a few, like Vincent Van Gogh. Yep, yes, Vincent Van Gogh. You know Vincent Van Gogh, the artist. Then we have Leonardo da Vinci. Yes, Leonardo da Vinci. He has high spatial intelligence. So I hope you would stop saying that those who are painting, those who are sketching, you'd ask them to stop doing it because it makes them dull. They're actually intelligent that way. That's where their intelligence is put in place. That's how their mind works when they are able to sketch, when they're able to paint. So do not pattern everybody just like how you pattern. How you understand intelligence, because not everybody is like you. You have to understand that. Musical. Yes, the musical intelligence. There is such thing as musical intelligence. Yes, of course, the singers, the musicians, composers, they see patterns in the beat, the notes, the sound. They can form something out of it. That is intelligence that not everybody possess. The musically inclined, they are musically intelligent. So, well, because we are so fanatic of music, because we need music wherever we are, whatever our profession would be, music is always there for us. Michael Jackson is high musical intelligence. Does he not? Yes, he does. Then we have Beethoven. Let's go classical. Beethoven, Mozart. Yes, Mozart and Beethoven, the classic, the classical and very high musical intelligence. Yes. Okay, they're geniuses actually in when we talk about music. Next is the bodily kinesthetic. Yes, this is where dancing is. Yes, dancing. This is actually my focus because I wanna, I don't know, I wanna talk about my friend who is very good at dancing. And I wanna tell you, my friend's RC stories because they are actually performers. They are intelligent. Romel Alvarez, the R in the RC stories, is bodily kinesthetic. He is intelligent that way. And Clemente Avalos, the C in the RC stories, he is musically intelligent. So music and bodily kinesthetic, very good pair, don't you think? So yes, dancing is an intelligence. You cannot just say, oh, stop dancing, it makes you dull. Why don't you study math and English and science to make you intelligent? You have to recognize that they already possess that intelligence. They have intelligence, it's just you fail to recognize it. So the problem is you. Okay? So I hope that after watching this video, you're going to try to ponder, are you just being so judgmental on how intelligence should be? Or you're just being biased about intelligence. Interpersonal intelligence. Interpersonal intelligence, usually our leaders have this because this intelligence is what makes them good at making connections with people. How they convince people to do this and do that. How they affect people's lives, like they're influencers. So let's just say most YouTubers have this intelligence. Interpersonal, because they're able to influence people. That's interpersonal intelligence. Like Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi was a lawyer, an Indian lawyer. So Mahatma Gandhi has a very high interpersonal intelligence. So he actually led India to independence from the British colony. Okay, next is intrapersonal intelligence. This is an intelligence where a person knows or understands himself. Not everyone can do that. Sometimes it would take a long, long time before we know ourselves. This should actually be the beginning of how things should be, because once we understand the goings on of ourself, the inner self, we can do most things because we understand ourselves. Okay, but it's intelligence. And I say it is not patterned to everyone. Helen Keller. Helen Keller is an author. Okay, that's one name I can tell you. Helen Keller. Aristotle. Yes, so we go classic. And Sigmund Freud. Yes, Sigmund Freud has intrapersonal intelligence. Okay, so they have to spend time pondering on things so they could share it to others. So mostly the intrapersonal, they are writers or they could be philosophers in a way, but philosophers would belong to the existential intelligence when they go deeper, ask the deeper questions to understand the bigger picture. I think the existentialists always have to begin with intrapersonal. You begin with the intrapersonal, the self, before you can venture deeper questions to ask to make sense of the universe. Okay? So those are the multiple intelligences. So I'm not an expert, but this is just an eye-opener for those who still have a close mind about intelligence. So if your child starts dancing, that's an intelligence that your child has. We do not just call it a talent. Yes, it is a talent, and it's an intelligence at the same time. So, math, English, all subjects, whichever subject your child is good at, that's where his or her intelligence is pointed at. So do not force the issue that only math and English and science, those who know those subjects better, are the intelligent ones. Perhaps it is time that we change our perspective on intelligence. My friend Rumel Alvarez, he's a very good dancer. He is intelligent that way, very cunning. If you could have just seen him dance, you would be wowed. I hope, I know, someday he would be dancing again and he would wow you in his videos. He's just working on some stuff. Okay, so we're gonna watch out for that. And here's my friend Rumel Alvarez for the RC stories. Let's hear what he has to say.
Hi mga ka-stories! So, gusto ko lang mag-congratulate kay Miss Janelle Cogtas, Teacher Janelle Cogtas. At last, monetized na ang channel mo. Congratulations, Teacher Janelle! So, keep it up. Sana sisikap din tayo. Char, patience is a virtue. Yes, congratulations, Teacher Janelle! Dahil monetized ka na. So, hopefully guys, supportahan niyo din kami. Janelle Cogtas, and of course, my channel, RC Stories. Again, congratulations, Teacher Janelle Cogtas.